Hey there, Sagittarius. Welcome to your reading for the week of August 19th. This week you have this Cancer card. It says, nurture all you love. Take time to care for your well-being and nurture the things you love. You have this lighthouse. It says, you're a light that can't be hidden, so don't even try to dim it for anyone. And so it's time to shine here for you, Sagittarius. And you start off with the Death card. The Death card has the sun coming up between the two pillars on the Moon card. And I always say that it kind of says that you are leaving a moon period behind. A moon period is a period of confusion, fantasy, secrets, you know, not being able to see the path that you're on, or maybe struggling to understand the journey that you're on. And look at this, you have this going forward card. There's this path that goes straight towards the sun. So again, I think it's your time to shine here, Sagittarius. It's like time for you to, you know, get out of this energy right here. And it's time for you to step into a much better, you know, light-filled energy. You have the Death card, the Five of Swords, and the Six of Pentacles. The Death card, of course, represents like the change or things changing in your life. And I feel that also the Death card can represent embracing kind of like a childlike energy. And you fire signs keep getting this like childlike energy, or this energy of needing to like embrace your inner child. And the child on the Death card is the only person on the Death card that isn't afraid of death, that isn't afraid of change. So I think that, you know, embracing the change or working in new directions would be a really good idea for you. We have this white rose on the Death card's banner, and the white rose on the Death card kind of represents the light at the end of the tunnel. You know, it says that you're getting to the end of a transformation or change, and you're opening up to a much better energy. So I do like to see that. You have the Five of Swords. Five of Swords can represent a separation, or, you know, kind of winning at all cost. It can represent conflict. I don't really see any other conflicts going on here. And you also have the Five of Pentacles as well, and the Five of Cups. So 555, by the way, 555 is the number of change. So clearly there's a big change that's going on for you at this time. But what I will say is kind of what I get in this middle row. You end with the Justice card, and the Justice card is coming up in the area of the good stuff. So this here, to me, would represent like the fear that you are going to invest in something, you're going to give something your energy, and you're not going to get the energy back. So I kind of feel that those six cards at the top here, like from here over, are just saying that maybe there is a little bit of resistance this week, because you're fearing that if you give something your time, effort, or attention, or energy, or anything else, that it's not going to be returned to you. And that's really the thing that I think, you know, that's like the resistance point that I would work on if I were you this week, is, you know, kind of fearing that you are not going to get something out of something that you're investing in. One thing I will say is that, you know, you need to trust the evidence. We have Justice and the Six of Pentacles. If you put energy in, what do you get back? I think we only need to worry about, you know, investing in something if we're over investing, right? If we're giving too much. So if you're like meeting a person, or if you're starting a new job or a new business or whatever, you know, just give a little bit first, and then see what happens, and then keep going. I think as long as you take your time, then you won't get hurt, and there's nothing to worry about. But I think if you overinvest, you know, that's where the challenges could come in. With the Death card, you have the King of Pentacles. Definitely a positive financial change. In the top row here, you end with the Eight of Pentacles. And the King of Pentacles is a card of wealth or abundance. And so I feel for a lot of you that you could be trying to improve your, you know, your wealth prospects, or you're trying to make more money, or maybe you're trying to do things that can make you more money. And sorry, I'm just throwing things all over the place here. So again, I think you could be doing things to improve your finances. With the Five of Swords, you have the Three of Swords. Again, I think this is the fear of being heartbroken again. And again, this does not have to be love. It's like maybe you've given your time, effort, and attention to businesses, your ideas, your goals, your wishes, your dreams, and it hasn't worked out. So I think, you know, this Mercury retrograde in particular that we're in right now, and which is ending this week, by the way, has really been a lot about healing. You know, part of the retrograde was in Leo, part of it's in Virgo. And so, you know, being in Virgo, it kind of makes sense that all of these cards of healing come up. The Three of Swords is about needing to pull those swords out of your own heart through forgiveness or through healing. And I feel a lot of you could be doing that. With the Six of Pentacles, you have the Devil. Yes, again, like I said, I think that this first part of the reading is very simple. I think it's just the fear of getting sucked into something, and but it's kind of like not wanting to necessarily give it a full commitment, or being fearing that something is going to take advantage of you. For a lot of you, it could be a boss. It's like, I'm sure you've all had one of those bosses where it's like slowly but surely they add more and more responsibilities, onto you, even though you can barely get the job done in the first place, right? So I kind of feel like the Devil is encouraging you to invest a little bit and to kind of like take your time. I think that it's great to over deliver, but one thing that I kind of do agree with people on nowadays is that, for the most part, like back in the day, like my grandfather, he worked at a factory, right? Or like something. And he worked his way from literally from the bottom to the top, right? Through hard work and all that other good stuff. But it really doesn't work like that anymore, right? It's like back in the day, sure, if you over delivered, if you put more energy in, it's like you were probably more likely to get promoted. But it seems to me like nowadays that's not true. So, is it worth it to overwork yourself to death? The answer is no. So I kind of feel like this is talking about healthy give and take, especially in work. I think if you have a job, it would be better for you to just like stick to your job description. Don't necessarily go above and beyond right now. And that doesn't mean there won't be moments where you can go above and beyond, but just for right now, see how things go. See if you get more energy back. And if you do, then it might be a good time to over deliver, right? You have this Caduceus card, says you will receive news from afar. You have a serpent and it says a sly and subtle approach is needed. I kind of just said that kind of like being more subtle, just doing what you're supposed to do would be a good idea, especially in work or business. This is coming up in the area of what's coming towards you. So again, there could be an opportunity. And I kind of get that feeling here, Sagittarius. I just have to say that your middle card, you have the Nine of Swords, the Knight of Swords, and the Page of Cups in this, and this is showing up in the middle of those two cards. The Knight of Swords says, don't rush, right? It's a card that he is being too hasty. He is like trying to force something to happen. This horse looks stressed out, right? He is like forcing it to run. So I feel for a lot of you that there could be an opportunity that you are receiving. I actually feel like it's a good opportunity. I just feel it's saying like, don't rush into it too quickly. I think that's where the disappointments are coming from. And the other thing that I will tell you about the Nine of Swords is, if this is love for you, for example, which I do feel for some, like not all of you, but for most of you, I feel this is work related, but for some of you, it could be love. You have the Page of Cups here. Sometimes I think that we get hurt in love. So it's like the next person we meet, we almost do too much, which kind of turns them off. And so I feel like the Nine of Swords is saying, just be cool, calm, collected, be yourself, right? And just see what happens, right? The Nine of Swords says, don't repeat a cycle. Don't stay stuck in a comfort zone. This blanket right here represents a comfort blanket. And the card itself kind of says that he is stuck in a comfort zone. So I feel this is saying, stay open, and be flexible and don't try to rush something, because it's almost like something very delicate is trying to present itself to you with this Page of Cups. For some of you, it could be a love connection, but really, I don't know. I feel this is maybe a little bit bigger than a love connection. This fish right here, I always say, is part of his imagination. That fish might not exist, but whether the fish is real or not doesn't matter. He needs to grab onto that fish and bring it down to earth. And that's how I always look at the Page of Cups. So there could be like an opportunity that's coming in for you where you're going to, you have this serpent card. It says a sly, subtle approach is needed. So if you are getting any new opportunity this week, I would like take your time, go with the flow. Don't push it. Don't try to force it to happen. I think that's going to be your best bet. With the Nine of Swords, you have the Four of Wands. This would represent setting yourself free from the Nine of Swords. The Four of Wands is really a card of completion. It is a card of marriage and stuff, but really it comes up when we are completing one stage or one part of our journey, and we are going to have a celebration on the other side of these Four of Wands by kind of crossing through those Four of Wands. And to do that, we just have to complete something. So I feel this is saying, if there's anything that you've been overthinking, overanalyzing, any comfort zone that you're in, bringing that to an end will set you free from the Nine of Swords. With the Knight of Swords, you have the Temperance card. Literally patience. Literally what I said. I get this feeling. I got this right at the beginning, and that's why I said it. You cannot make this up, Sagittarius. I feel like there is a need for patience. It's almost like the less you do, the better, And I'm not saying don't do your job if this is a job, for example. But it's almost as if if you just, you know, did what was right in front of you, that would be best. Same thing in a relationship. It's like, if you're meeting a new person here, I feel like it's one of those things where if you could just be on your purpose all day, and then when you, you know, and like set, you know, dates for this person, that would be 10 times better than trying to text this person, whoever this person is, right? Than trying to text them all day. It's like, I know it's, you know, easy to get excited at the beginning of a connection, but it's almost like it would be better for you to protect this right now by kind of just playing it cool, right? And it's not like you're playing a game or something like that. Just, it's just saying, like, I think it's just saying, don't try to make this something it isn't, or I don't even know what the right words are, but there you go. With the Page of Cups, you have the Page of Pentacles. Yeah, something new. Page of Pentacles would say, take the time to learn something new. Page of Pentacles is a card of studiousness, and obviously you can't know all of a subject right away, right? So if you're entering into or getting a new opportunity at this time, I would say for like the next like 3 or 4 weeks, if any new opportunities come in for you, this is just saying, you know, it's okay to start from ground zero. It's okay to, you know, start from the beginning and see what you can learn. You know, if it's a person, you know, take your time getting to learn the person. Take the time to, you know, see what the person is about. Same thing with a job or a business or an idea that you have. It's like saying there is no rush. And the Knight of Swords is really standing out to me in your reading. It's a card of rushing. So I feel for a lot of you, this is saying like, take your time. Next, in the area of messages from your future self, you have this going forward card and you have this freedom card. So the Four of Wands is the card of freedom in the tarot, and you have this freedom card here. So you're clearly setting yourself free. Like I said, I think you're on this path to the sun. You know, it's like you're on this path to excellence, or you're on this path to shining bright, or something along those lines. And I think that it's been, you know, kind of like a difficult journey. You have the Five of Cups, Five of Pentacles, and the Three of Pentacles. The Five of Cups says, do not pay attention to what was lost. It says, focus on the new thing that's behind you, because it will give you the bridge and the castle. You know, I always say the fives have the easiest solutions. And so the solution with the Five of Cups is to realize that maybe what you regret, or maybe the sadness that you're feeling over a loss, it's something that you don't enjoy any longer anyway. So if you lost an ex that you're thinking about, it's like, maybe you know that you wouldn't go back to the person anyway, so there's no reason for you to be sad about it in the first place. But there's clearly something new right behind you. A new opportunity, something that you are going to be working on in the very near future. You know, you have the Eight of Pentacles in the good stuff, and the Eight of Pentacles would say that you're discovering something to work on, or you're discovering something to give your energy to. You have the Five of Pentacles. I don't know, I think a lot of people feel like this right now, just, you know, kind of feel like they're being left out in the cold, or feeling lonely, or feeling like they don't have the resources necessary to accomplish their wildest dreams. And, you know, it's a little bit difficult and challenging, because, I blame Neptune and Pisces. We have Neptune and Pisces right now, which is like the big impossible dream. So everybody's like got these crazy ideas, or everybody sees at least the things that would make them their lives better. Like, maybe you've never taken a vacation before, but also, maybe because Neptune is in Pisces, you keep imagining going on a vacation, or maybe you keep dreaming about going on a vacation, but you're also saying to yourself, restriction. Saturn in Pisces. We have Saturn in Pisces right now, which is like the kind of the wet blanket on the dream, right? But the good news is Saturn in Pisces. I think that, yes, Saturn with Neptune right there is a little bit of a wet blanket. I also feel that if you do the work, you can absolutely accomplish your dream. So the Five of Pentacles, the solution is to focus on your strengths and not your weaknesses. And I feel if you double down on your strengths, then you will kind of realize that you can accomplish something much easier. I'll tell you something. It's like, you know, me and my team, we've been exploring like a new like business direction, and we've done a lot of research on competitors and things like that. And it's like what I thought was required to do this, what was like way up here. What is actually required, or like the bar that most of the competition is setting, is down here. And it's not like a criticism of those people. It's just like, I think as humans, sometimes we make things harder than they need to be. And I feel like the Five of Pentacles is saying, you know, don't make something harder than it actually needs to be. You have the Three of Pentacles. And you know, going back to over-delivering, by the way, is that, you know, sometimes things are simple for a reason. You know, speaking of business, it's like sometimes the reason that people do things a simple way and don't provide, you know, don't go totally above and beyond, is because it's overwhelming, right? So maybe you think that you have to do all this extra stuff, but really, instead of, you're creating confusion instead of just giving people what they want, right? And this could be in love, business, everywhere. And so sometimes I think the simple, focusing on simple and quality is the answer. The Three of Pentacles is a card of quality, and he has just followed these plans that she has presented to him, and he has done a good job. That's the whole point, is he has just done what he's been asked to do, and he's done a great job doing it. So I think that is, and I don't know, because I don't really feel this intuitively necessarily, but I kind of feel this in your reading, that the reading is saying, you know, keeping whatever you're doing simple, relationships, businesses, your love life, work, your health, simple is going to be the answer for you. With the Five of Cups, you have the Ace of Wands, new inspiration. So I feel really good about this, because this would tell me that you are turning around and you're getting the inspiration of something new that you could be working on with the Eight of Pentacles. With the Five of Pentacles, you have the Eight of Wands. Yes, quick success. This is like a quick turnaround here, especially with these cards of restriction like the Fives. The Eight of Wands would say you are swiftly moving towards the Eight of Pentacles, which would be, you know, success, financial success, growth, and all that other stuff. With the Three of Pentacles, you have the Chariot. The Chariot, of course, is a victory or success. So like I said, I feel like there could be a big victory or success coming in for you. You have this waxing crescent moon. This is showing up in the area of the good stuff. It says, have faith in your dreams. I think the whole entire reading is basically saying, yeah, there are probably a million reasons why you can't do something, or you can't take that vacation, or you can't do that thing. There's probably a lot of reasons, Five of Pentacles. But if there is one good reason you should do it, like your mental health, right? Going on a vacation is great for mental health. Then I think that should be enough to motivate you to get to work and figure out how to make it happen. You have this full moon in Aquarius. It says, show the world the real you. Like I said at the beginning of the reading, it seems to me like the light is on you, or that you are kind of like stepping into the light and you are shining bright at this time. So you could be getting a lot of attention. You have the Eight of Pentacles, the Justice card, and the Eight of Wands. The Eight of Pentacles is diligent work. He is just, again, just doing one thing. If you notice, he is only focusing on completing these pentacles. And before you know it, he is going to be done. He only has one more pentacle over here to complete. And before he knows it, he's done with what he has to do. So again, I kind of get the feeling that some of you might also be working on something that is very complex. But I think if you focus in on like one thing that makes it complete, then you are going to complete something before you know it. So get to work on the right thing. You have the Justice card. Again, I do feel there's definitely some sort of justice coming in for you here. I think it's the balance, like you putting in energy and what you get out of the things you're doing. And because you have the Justice card, you're doing things more in balance. And because of that, you're finding more success, which is good. You have the Eight of Wands again. So Eight of Wands is definitely quick success. We go this way, Four of Wands, Eight of Wands, Eight of Wands. And so Eight of Wands would be you focusing on the good stuff, because Nine of Swords, Five of Pentacles is not good stuff, right? And I think for you to set yourself free, that the Eight of Wands is kind of like aiming in a direction and aiming at exactly what you want out of life and cutting out the rest. With the Eight of Pentacles, you have the Page of Wands. I kind of feel like there is a new way that you could be working. We have three pages going this way here. Page of Cups, Page of Pentacles, Page of Wands. It's almost like you're discovering a new or a better way to do what you do for work. And I love it. This could also be love. Like you could be discovering a new way to invest your time in relationships, and that could be better as well. With the Justice card, you have the Wheel of Fortune. Very good. This is your card. So whenever you show up as yourself, this puts you in a position of power and strength. You show up twice, Temperance and Wheel of Fortune. So luck could be turning in your favor, but I also feel that you are just present. You know, to me, when you show up twice, especially as the major arcana versions of yourself, it says that you're really just present in the energy. So that's good. With the Eight of Wands, you have the Four of Pentacles. Yeah, I think you're creating more stability in your life as well, or you're focusing on kind of like foundational work at this time, and that would be a good thing as well. You have this Caution card. Yep. I would be careful of like too many people coming at you, right? I would be careful of like other people's opinions or what other people have to say to you. You see all these animals that are like running towards this lady. And so I feel like you could be getting a lot of information this week, but I would, you know, filter through the information you're receiving. You have this Affair card, so this card is a good card for love. You do have three pages here in the Four of Wands, so if you want love, you know, this could be like the beginnings of something. This card is not like a cheating affair, it's just like a, you know, love coming into your life. So, you know, there could be something very new, very fresh, something that I want to throw away apparently. So I would just, you know, take your time, like I said. And it's almost like, I want to say as well, it's almost like the least... the less pressure you put on this, the better it will be. So like I said, if you can just, when you like meet this person, right? I would set dates and like, I would only really talk to them on those dates. It doesn't mean you're like, you're ignoring them or playing games or whatever, but like I think it's like you're more, what the reading is really saying is that you, in those moments where you're like present with the person, you're really present with the person. You're really focused on it, right? And I think that's what this is trying to get at, is it's like saying it would be better for you. Three of Pentacles is a card of quality. So if you're meeting a person, I'm telling you right now, I think it would be better for both people to understand that in those quality moments where you're actually with the person, you're not just like this, you know, sitting on the toilet texting them, right? Those moments are going to be, doubling down on those moments are going to make things a million times better in the future, is what I feel like this is saying. You have this assertion card. This is a card of being bold and assertive. Again, if you have a boss that's like telling you like, oh, do this, do that, like maybe you have to stand up for yourself, and I would. You have this indecision card. Yeah, if you don't make a decision, the universe is going to make it for you. And how funny is this? You have the Tower on the bottom of the clarifying deck. So the Tower kind of represents, if you don't do it, I will, as in the universe will make a decision for you. And I kind of got that feeling on this indecision card, that it was really, it's like really saying that if you have a choice to make right now, if you don't make it, the universe will. So I would just do whatever it is. You have this isolation card. And maybe this is why, by the way. I think you could be attracting a person who is like isolating themselves, and you could be responsible. You're a Sagittarius, you are the adventurer, right? So you could be making someone more adventurous, or you could be pulling them out of their comfort zone. And I just kind of feel like that, like slower, more, compassionate type of approach to this person would pay off really, really well. Stuff like this kind of gives me the feeling that you could be attracting a really good person who's like maybe been hurt before or had a big hurt. So it's like kind of like that slower approach might do you better, and I think they'll open up faster. So there you go. But this looks really good, Sag. I love where this is going for sure. So thank you for being here, and definitely enjoy your week.